Stefan Brogren here from the principal's office. Hallways of Degrassi, not a principal's office. I can't believe I still even bother explaining this. Guys, this is a recap show. After Degrassi, we like to talk about it. I like to talk about my personal feelings of the show, maybe get you guys a little upset, maybe get you a little excited for what's coming up. So, this is episode what? Krista, help me here. Sorry, what is it?
1326.
Close to me. Whole Krista, get on it. You'll cut this, right? Okay.
No, I can't. I thought I could dance with you and maybe pretend to be a lesbian, but I can't because I'm not.
Oh, thank heavens.
Becky's not gay. Becky is not gay, and it's like she is trying. She is so in love with Imogen as a friend, and she just wants her in her life. And I think we've all been waiting to see, like, what is up with her? What does she want?
You're my first girlfriend at Degrassi who isn't my girlfriend, if you know what I mean.
I do.
Me and Fiona were inseparable. But now we barely even talk.
So sad.
Yeah. But I heard a rumor that though girlfriends come and go, best friends stay for life.
Best friends?
Definitely.
She's the loneliest character on Degrassi, which I kind of adore about her. She is this what should be a popular girl and was probably very popular in Florida. And she's always had a problem connecting with people, and she's had that connection. She's just scared she's going to lose that really good friend that she's made out of Imogen. I'm really curious to see what happens with Jack in the future. Hope she's not a jackass. Okay, I've regained my composure. Krista, what are we talking about next?
Yes, thank you so much, especially to my wonderful boyfriend, Connor.
Booyah!
I'm starting to feel bad for Jess, man. We are just giving her every awful scenario. I mean, do you guys remember when she was on the top of the pyramid for Spirit Squad or for Power Squad, and she basically, let's be honest, she had diarrhea at the top of the pyramid, and she was taking those pills for weight loss, and it's a constant flow of like boobs and diarrhea. Oh God, this one's gonna be hard.
You remember when I told you I'd wait for you?
Of course.
I shouldn't have said that. I should have just kissed you.
They're back at the house, and Zig leans in on Maya, and there's a little tension there, I think, for the first time when they talk about, you know, the rules of the house.
But rules are rules. Good night, Maya Matlin.
Even through all the crap that he's going through right now, I think he's found a little bit of his self-empowerment, and then that's a good thing.